Every 28 days, a woman goes through what is called her period. But which sanitary pad do you use? Whisper, Stay Free, Sophie, Carefree, or something different? Do you know what goes in making your favorite sanitary pads? If you don't, then let me tell you that it's scary. Apart from plastic, there are many toxic chemicals in them that are linked to urinary tract infections, rashes, toxic shock syndrome, infertility, and even cancer. It is extremely important to use the right product, which is not only safe but is also comfortable, practical, and budget friendly. So what should you use to make your period a happy period? Let us find out. Hello friends, welcome to FitTuber. To find out the best menstrual product, I checked online and offline and bought almost every option that is available in the Indian market. The research of this video was not just limited to online sources and books, but I also got in touch with gynecologists and many women to understand the issue at the practical level. Starting with the commercial sanitary pads, which include the napkins by Whisper, Stay Free, Sophie, Carefree, and other brands. These are obviously the most popular among Indian women. And why not? They are cheap, convenient, and simply use and throw. But what most brands don't tell you is that these pads are also the most damaging for your health. Yes, that's because they are loaded with not one but many toxic chemicals. The most dangerous is dioxin released by chlorine, which is used to bleach the sanitary pad so that it looks more white. Even though brands try to dodge this by claiming low quantities of dioxin released, but it's just a clever way to keep the show running. Even at low doses, dioxin finds its way directly into the bloodstream, seriously damaging the health of a woman. WHO has labeled dioxin as cancer-causing. Then you might have faced rashes and even infections in your intimate areas during a period. Most women today have accepted it to be normal. Well, the plastic lining of the pad is to be blamed, that becomes the breeding ground for bacteria and yeast. It is these microorganisms that cause rashes and infections. Then synthetic sanitary napkins are laced with odor neutralizers and artificial fragrances. These cheap chemical components may become the reason for irritation, allergies, complication in reproductivity, to the extent of infertility. Most brands that boast of super absorbent sanitary pads use a gel which is made of petroleum-derived bleached polymers that may have many harsh chemicals. Apart from all the health concerns, these sanitary pads, since they are non-biodegradable, are a menace to our environment. One commercial sanitary pad costs just Rs. 5, so the average per period cost of using sanitary pads is around 60 Rs. The second type of menstrual products are the tampons. Extremely popular in the Western countries, tampons are fast becoming a thing among Indian women as well. Sadly, tampons are worse than a sanitary napkin. Why? Well, that's because a tampon is made up of all the toxic stuff that's used in a sanitary pad, but the worst part is that tampons need to be inserted within the body. That's the reason women using tampons are more prone to the toxic shock syndrome. In this condition, the bacteria and yeast growth goes so high that it can prove fatal. That is why it is recommended to change a tampon every 4 hours without fail. Although even if you regularly change tampons, you cannot protect yourselves from other toxic chemicals that go in making a tampon. Tampons are popular among women who prefer an active lifestyle, as once they are inserted, they do not give you a wet feeling, but that's at a cost of your health. More so, tampons are costlier than sanitary napkins, and an average cost of one period would be around 120 rupees. The third type of products available are the cloth pads. These are washable pads which can be reused and have an average life of around 3 years. Contrary to the previous two options, a cloth pad is environment friendly. But the problem with them is that you need to accept the hassle to wash them every time before they can be reused. And worse, the cloth pad should be changed every 4 hours. So if you are a working woman, a cloth pad isn't that convenient for you. But is it safe? Absolutely. Indian women since ages have always used cloth during their menses. There was a huge marketing campaign aimed at discouraging the women to stop using cloth pads, as it may cause deadly diseases. Well, it's partially true. So make sure that you sun dry the cloth pads after washing. Once that is done, the cloth pad is perfectly sterilized and is 100% safe to be reused. One cloth pad will cost you around 250 rupees, and you would probably need at least 4 to get through one period. If they last for 3 years, the average cost of one period is just rupees 27. As people are getting more and more aware of the potential health hazards and environment risks of a sanitary napkin, brands are coming up with biodegradable sanitary pads. These pads are definitely